So we got a still picture too.
This is it recording?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is going to be week four. What I would like to see for this week, go ahead and let them go. Are the dogs driving into the box with a nice deep nose? And if this happens, I think she's a little far away, so step into the box and make it easier. And I'd almost prefer you were directly behind him, so step back in, make it easy for the first time. It's okay, we'll figure it out. Good. She waited for a nice, calm, deep nose, and then just stay there, don't move around. And what I'm looking for is this self-driven behavior whenever you feel the need, you click. I'm looking for self-driven behavior where he's going into the box, calm, clicking, coming out, and resetting himself back into that hole. And you can start doing this from different directions so he learns to go in from different ways. Good. She's waiting for calmness because he had a problem of being a little twitchy in the box. Now move to the side somewhere, or move up. Move off that way to the side. Good. Good. So for this week, what I would like her to do, go ahead and let him get back into the box. She's going to say his name very quietly. He's going to come out. She's going to go blank and ignore him. No feedback from mom. Now this time he's going to go back in. I let her reward kind of quickly there, but he's going to go back in. She's going to say his name again because it took him a minute to restart. So I'll just reward that quickly. Name?
Heart.
Blank. Again. No, I want you to say his name. And now we're at the part where he's self-starting. I would only click quickly if he was having a hard time going back to the box and figuring out what to do. This, he's just slightly distracted because there's people walking around behind me and softly. Click, right away, good. And he was almost beating you. It was borderline, but that's okay. All right, we're gonna do it again. Steps in because he's stressed by you being that far out. There you go, just right there. Just move, don't move your feet, you just relax. It hasn't been long enough that I would have to try to restart him. Try his name again. But don't be so impatient. Don't start moving around. Just wait for him to, he hadn't stopped working, it hadn't been that long. Because we don't want to have to, you know, be the one to react to that. Let him figure it out. If he's badgering your food, get him off your hand, and if you need to, you could take, well, here he goes. Quietly say his name. Click. Oh,
that
it would have been,
bad.
You should have been a lot
bad.
Quicker. Yeah, you should have been a lot quicker on the click.
Yeah. So I feel like I should stick my hand in the box.
No, you don't need to stick your hand in the box. No, absolutely not. I'm hostile. Don't come here. I'm not something to mess with.
He's trying to make me make eye contact.
He wants you to interact with him. That's why you don't.
I know.
And because he kind of solicits you to, you know, like he wants you to interact with him. And this is a self-driven behavior. And he wasn't doing this earlier, but that's okay. This is good for people to see him work through this. Take a step closer. Stare they get, because it's like the gears are turning, the smoke's going to start coming up here, and then they figure it out. Now he's looking for freebies, whatever, that doesn't work, trying to figure out what's going to work, but the only thing that's going to work is sticking your little face in that box. Now we're going to talk about distraction. So we use his name. Once he's desensitized to his name, now stomp your feet. Stomp your feet a little. Oh, there you go. Whatever. So the next one I like to do is like my feet, and then just go blank again when they come out. They got to learn that none of that is their business. And if this was my training session at home, because he did so good earlier, I would have put him up on that, and he's kind of tired, but we wanted to use him for the demo. Now touch his side. Oh, there you go, click.
Yes.
Good. So now he's desensitized to that, now we'll go and touch his side. You reset after every time he comes out. Oh, bend down. Sometimes just the motion of bending over is enough to bring him out. Click. Right away. Good. All right. So we're going to start adding in distractions for this week. His last video, he was really going in and out, doing really well, coming back. I think we kind of made him tired, but that's okay. This showed a lot of good things that you can problem solve. If he's not diving into the box and coming out, diving into the box and coming out, but by next week, okay, so you guys have this week still to make that beautiful, right? Nice big nose for her. His calm nose is doing good. Start taking it in a little bit more distracting areas. But I really want to see that self-driven behavior of going to the box, coming back, to the box, coming back for the clicks. And then once we have that, and once we have nice deep noses and that consistency, right? And you can start off easy. Remember, every session you do, if you want, stick your hand in the box and then work your way out, but quickly. And then be right by the box. Hold on, let me grab a box real quick. That's okay. And some of you guys, I see food in your boxes. Don't leave food in your box. Yes? You can, because next week we're going to start wearing harnesses. But you can. So, well, after the following week, everyone brings. I'm just starting my dog for the session. I might go back to, you know, click that a few times, put my hand here, do that a few times, stand up, have it really good here, click here, and I might stand right behind. quick. They have to come out and then start moving around the clock and getting some distance. But remember, work your way little and then build strong. Maybe take only a few clicks. Like maybe I just do a few clicks right here and then I can move behind the dog. And I want to see that self-driven behavior. And then once we have that and they know to put their nose in, lay down, have a nice deep nose, some calmness in the box, and I reward them, then I'm going to add in Phoebe. And they come out. Remember, go no feedback from you. Ignore them. They're going to go back in the box. Phoebe. Until the point that they don't come out, and I'm going to click that and reward them. Because now I'm not working on duration. I'm just working on distraction. So remember, don't try to train two things at once. Do one thing. So if I'm working on duration without distractions, then I'm working on duration and flow into the box, going in and out, in and out, in and out. Then when I come back to make it harder, I'm not going to be way back there. I might be closer. Phoebe, come out. And you wait for them not to come out, and then you click and feed it. Then the next time, maybe it's arm movement, because you know some of those dogs are looking at the corner of their eye. So maybe I do this. They come out, I go blank. Over and over again until this pretty soon is in Phoebe or whatever. You know, and then I do, or movement for me, sound for me, to the point where I can smack on the wall, you know, and then I go to touching them. Touch. But I go back to position, I don't lean over. Touch. Touch until they don't move. Click and reward that. Then I do it all over the place. And then I'll put both hands till I can touch. Because then the next step is I'm going to grab them by their shoulders and pull. And what I want is for them to actively resist me and try to put their nose in the box. I'm going to click and reward that push into the box. So pretty soon, I can have them, and I can try to pull them out, and the dog is scrambling to get back in the box because they know that that's the sweet spot, right? And so we work on distractions that way because later on, like I said, that's going to turn into our odor obedience where we want them to stick to odor. We want it very clear where that odor is at so that they understand what their job is. Find the odor, have that indication, hold that indication until they hear that click at all costs. Because you're going to be at a trial, and you guys saw that those of you that went to the trial, you could be at the trial and there's all kinds of things that are distracting. Your dog was slightly more distracted because he was getting up and going, and you know, I, one of those teacher things that had eyes back, like I knew what was going on back here, and, but that's okay. Because we don't want to teach them in a clean environment where everything is super quiet, because then they can only focus in super quiet. We come in here, if you come for our drills, we're laughing and talking and watching dogs and doing stuff, and sometimes people come for our drills and they get kind of irritated because they're not used to that. But that's real world situations, right? Our dog should be able to ignore that, and that's what we're doing now, focusing them. This is your job. Everything else you ignore, right? Yes?
I want to revisit her question.
Yes.
I usually train off-leash at home. Should we be training
with a... I'm not worried about this week because when we start doing multiple boxes and stuff, we're going to start adding in a search because I showed you guys last week or the last time we met, holding the harness, being calm, starting them, using a search word. We're going to build that in later. Right now, we're just working on indication.
Okay.
So you can have them off-leash at home, but I would start... If you use a leash here and it's distracting, then use a leash at home so it's not distracting, okay? But we'll talk about harnesses and stuff. Anyway, right now, all I want is that bouncing back and forth behavior, and next week I want to be able to, you know, and they're sticking in that box and they're not coming out. And I can say, Venom, are you sure? Come look over here. What a good girl. And they know to stick their head in that box and not come out. Because that's really what's going to help you at a trial. If you saw the dogs that were having a hard time working, sometimes we're outside, there's people walking by, there's noises, and, you know, we go to the park, there's all kinds of stuff going on at the park, and we want our dogs to be able to work through that, and this is what we're teaching. And that's why we spend so many weeks on the box, because this is such a critical behavior to learn, that if they can work in here through all the stuff that we throw at them, they can work wherever we go, right? I mean, we will start doing outside searches later on, and that has its own element of difficulty, but they'll be prepared for it, because they already have this behavior. That's why we spend so long building this indication and why it's okay, you know, if you're slightly behind, there's lots of time to catch up because a lot of the stuff I'm explaining, you really could do this in a few days and move and be ready to move forward. But you guys get a whole week to work on it. So that's why if you're not quite caught up because she needs to go back, take you a day, if that, to get those behaviors back to where you need them to be, okay? So the homework for next week, I want to see you be able to be anywhere and your dogs are diving in the box, click, coming out, box, click, coming out. That self-starting behavior where they know what their job is. They love the box. They want to stick their nose in that box. And then you start adding in distractions. So by hopefully next week, we have lots of distractions going on. Okay? Like, you can be done with your homework in 2 or 3 days. So you have that all the rest of the time to make it beautiful. So next week, expression for that is, I want everybody to have whatever harness you're going to use. I think is everyone going to use a harness? Anyone going to use a collar?
I've never used a harness, but I have one that goes with a seatbelt. Can I use that?
Yeah, there's different types of harnesses that you can look at. We could talk about harnesses. She can show some of, I like the ones that she has on her dogs, the Comfort Flex harnesses. But you're going to want to start putting equipment on them, okay, for next week. So bring your little harness or whatever you're going to use. It could be a special collar. It doesn't have to be a harness. Some people use like a thicker collar. This is, our dogs are really into context. You know, when they have their show lead on, they're showing. When they have their agility leash on, they're doing agility. So when we're doing scent detection, you have your special harness on. When I do Schutzen, my dogs have their Bartra harness, which is completely different. So what you're going to do next week is having the harness on. Like if I had Venom here, I'd see the box, and I already have all this behavior, and I have distractions down, and I'm going to stand here, and I'm going to tell her, I'm going to wait until she's calmly looking at the box. So gets distracted, whatever, but I'm going to stand here until she's calm, and she knows what we're doing. Voila. And I'll tell her her search command. Maybe you can say search, find it, whatever you want. And then they go in, and I click that. And then I'm going to bring her back on her harness, and we're going to do the same thing. She's staring at the hole, and she's quiet. I'm going to let her go and say her search word. And then when she's here, I'm just giving you the next step so she knows what to do for next week. Then she might pull on the leash a little bit, and that's where we're going to add in those distractions, right? But from now on, you're going to give that search command. You're going to freeze up, wait for your dog to focus and be calm, because they know what the hole is. They know their job. Put on.